Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all doing well. Today we'll commence with updates on Super Heavy Booster 4 and 5. Then we'll discuss Delegates leaving SpaceX. Then we'll look into an update on NASA's DART mission. And finally, we'll wrap up with China's Gaofen 11 launch. Before we dig into the details, we're excited to let you know that we've launched our new channel, Defense Today, to cater your latest updates about U.S. defense programs and some global movements as well. Check the link description below to give it a look and please subscribe. Let's start with our Starship update on Super Heavy Booster 4's progress and Booster 5's current conditions. On November 19th, SpaceX stacked up Super Heavy B-5's liquid methane tank on its liquid oxygen tank. Thus, the structural assembly for the booster was finally completed. Both of Starship's Super Heavy boosters are making good progress. It can be estimated that by the end of 2021, they'll be ready for their first major test campaigns. Welders are working in order to weld the oxygen and methane tanks together. However, Booster B-4's progress is slow, and the reason behind the slag is unclear. Now, as B-5 is about to be completed, SpaceX will soon find itself in a situation where a choice between B-4 and B-5 might occur, where the company will have to decide which one to proceed as the first orbital Starship test flight. The slow progress of Booster B-4 seemed less intense in recent weeks after the workers started closing out B-4's conduit. Moreover, the company started reinstalling Raptor engines. The heat shielding around those engines are also being installed. Elon Musk recently posted a photo of B-4, which clearly shows the heat shield. It can also be predicted that it will end up enclosing the entire external ring of the 20 Raptor boost engines, as well as their nozzles. After being completed, the heat shield is supposed to protect the sensitive structures of each engine. It will protect them during static fires, boost back, landing burns, and also re-entry. SpaceX is aiming to protect Super Heavy boosters without re-entry burns, contradicting Falcon boosters. The heat shields are expected to increase the efficiency of booster recovery. On November 17th, all the 29 Raptor engines were reinstalled on Booster 4, and a part of fixing the heat shields around the outer ring was done. Under current scenarios, the complete installation of the heat shield and installation of 7 aero covers will take several more weeks. SpaceX took just 2.5 weeks for stacking Booster 4, whereas stacking of Booster 5 was a lengthy span of more than 10 weeks. The company followed a different approach with Booster 5. Most of Booster 5's external plumbing, wiring, and equipment racks have been installed. Also, there's a chance of Raptor heat shields being installed during this phase instead of starting the process afterwards, like in case of Booster 4. Looking into Booster 4's current conditions, there's a fair chance that Super Heavy B-5 will take 4 to 5 weeks less than Booster 4 for being ready for initial tests. If the company fails to complete B-5 quite ahead of B-4, there will be a time soon when there will be 2 test-ready boosters but a single orbital-class stand. This scenario will lead to a choice, and SpaceX will have to make some tough decisions. Our next update is on Delegates leaving SpaceX, affecting the company's leadership. The departure of 2 members of SpaceX has led to a commotion in the world of space news. According to some, SpaceX's leadership related to rocket business has been shaken up. 2 vice presidents of different fields recently left the company. The 2 Delegates are Will Heltzley and Lee Rosen. Will Heltzley was the vice president of propulsion, and Lee Rosen was the vice president of mission and launch operations. Heltzley has remained with the company since 2009. Sources say he was taken off the Raptor engine development because of lack of progress in the program. This departure well explains the importance of the Raptor engines. We know how important these engines are for Starship. Elon Musk recently said about the second generation of the Raptor engines. He tweeted on November 16th that the generation of the Raptor engine has significant improvements in any way, but a complete design overhaul is necessary for the engine that can actually make life multiplanetary. It won't be called Raptor. Jacob McKenzie is working with SpaceX for more than 6 years now and is the leader of the Raptor engine development and production. Lee Rosen, on the other hand, was SpaceX Vice President of Mission and Launch Operations. According to sources, he left last week. He's been in the company since 2013. Ricky Lim, Senior Director of Mission and Launch Operations, is also rumored to have left the company. He's been in SpaceX since 2008. SpaceX did not reveal anything or comment on the recent modifications. The entire year was very significant for SpaceX. The company is still making progress with its Starship program. According to CEO Elon Musk, SpaceX's first orbital Starship flight will be launched soon, in January or February. Our next update is based on successful launch of NASA's DART mission on SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. On the 24th of November at 1:21 a.m. Eastern Time, a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket successfully launched the DART spacecraft from the launch pad of Vandenberg Space Force Base in California. After successful launch of the mission, SpaceX tweeted, "Deployment confirmed. NASA's DART is on its way to redirect an asteroid." NASA also wrote, "Asteroid Dimorphos, we're coming for you." Riding a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket, our DART mission blasted off at 1:21 a.m. EST, 6:21 UCT, launching the world's first mission to test asteroid deflecting technology. Lindley Johnson, NASA's Chief of Planetary Defense, said, "We're doing this work and testing this DART capability before we need it. We don't want to be flying an untested capability when we're trying to save a population on the Earth's surface." According to some sources, being an asteroid impact mission, the 622-kilogram DART spacecraft is destined to smash on the Dimorphos, an asteroid moon, by the month of September in 2022. DART will take approximately 10 months' time to reach Dimorphos. DART will travel at a speed of roughly 6.6 kilometers per second before hitting the Dimorphos while trying to alter its orbit around another asteroid named Deimos. With just 10 days left to reach Dimorphos, Lycia Cube will separate from DART spacecraft. DART will become the pathway of future planetary defense spacecraft that can intentionally redirect asteroids that threaten Earth, preventing catastrophic impacts. As it is a small-sized rock, DART will have to hit a bullseye with high precision when the asteroid system reaches its closest point to Earth along its orbit around the Sun, some 6.8 million miles away. After the spacecraft hits Dimorphos, scientists at NASA and the Applied Physics Laboratory will measure the changes Dimorphos' orbit around Deimos to find out whether the mission was a success or not. Andy Rivkin, the DART investigation team lead at Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Laboratory, said if the asteroid's orbit is increased by at least 73 seconds, curbing the revolution time around Deimos, then the mission would become a success. Despite Falcon 9 becoming a much larger launcher vehicle for DART, yet unavailability of powerful small-sat launchers to launch spacecraft for interplanetary missions, and most of them under development, had made NASA opt for this larger Falcon 9. It's estimated that once these small-sat launchers capable of supporting interplanetary missions become operational, they'll bring down the launch cost within $20 million. But such a thing will take a lot of time to develop. Though SpaceX has not launched any interplanetary launches earlier, yet they have the experience of sending two miniature NASA payloads earlier to much higher orbits of around 300,000 and 900,000 kilometers. With SpaceX, we have a good opportunity to get launches at lower costs. According to SpaceX executives, it's already known that launches with flight-proven Falcon 9 rockets will successfully bring down the cost within $15 to $25 million. So there's an excellent possibility of getting launch costs, which would be much easier to the estimated future small-sat launch costs. At present, while using SpaceX's $73 million Falcon 9, NASA is still saving almost $80 to $100 million as launch costs on ULA's most inexpensive vehicle, Atlas V, would be much higher with a price tag of $150 to $175 million. We'll end today's space updates with China's launch of the new Gaofen 11 high-resolution spy satellite. On the 19th of November at 8:51 p.m., a Chinese Long March 4B rocket had launched the Gaofen 11-03 satellite and deployed it into an orbital path of 247 by 694 kilometer altitude. That orbit has an inclination of 97.5 degrees. The rocket was launched from the Taiyuan Satellite Launch Center in northern China. This was the third Gaofen 11 reconnaissance satellite launch. Report says those satellites would be mainly used for land surveys, city planning, land rights confirmation, road network design, crop yield estimation, and disaster prevention and mitigation. As per reports, Gaofen 11 satellites in orbit have large 1.5-meter plus diameter apertures for optical remote sensing. Sources state that Gaofen satellites are part of the civilian China High-Resolution Earth Observation System comprised of optical, multispectral, hyperspectral, and synthetic aperture radar satellites. Gaofen 11 has the capability to return optical imagery at a resolution of around 10 centimeters. The Cheyenne branch of China Academy of Space Technology stated that the three Gaofen 11 satellites launched would be linked together to become operational. This launch was the 44th launch of China in 2021. Thus, it's seen that China has already surpassed their earlier launch records of 39 launches in 2018 and also in 2020. There's more than a month left in 2021, and China has more launches scheduled before the end of 2021. That's all for today, and oh yes, please don't forget to visit our new channel, Defense Today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.